Hello everyone, in this video I will go over my solution to the problem named working out. This problem is taken from code forces round 245 and it's div 1b. This problem is rated 1600 and is an interesting problem on grid DP and really tests one's understanding of grid DP. So in this problem we are given two people A and B. Person A starts from the cell 1,1 and needs to get to the cell n,n, and person B starts from the cell n,1 and needs to get to the cell 1,m, and this is basically a grid of size n by m, and they need to have their paths such that the paths intersect at exactly one point. Now we need to add up the values of those cells at which at least one of the two people went, but we need to not include that cell at which they intersected. So to show an example to make this clearer, let's take the first sample test case. In this test case we are given a grid of size 3x3 with these values in it. And A starts from cell 1,1 and needs to go to cell 3,3, and B starts from cell 3,1 and needs to get to cell 1,3. And in this case the optimal path for A would be to go to cell 100, then another 100, then 1 is their meeting point, then 100 and 100, and the optimal path for B would be 100, 100, 1, 100 and 100. So as you can add up these values, you'll see 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100, and that basically into 2 for the path of B will give you 800, and 800 is the correct output, which is the maximal gain possible in this sample test case. So let's make some observations before we look at the full solution. So let's take an example in a grid of size 5x6, in which let's fix the meeting point to be 3,4. Now we know that person A starts from cell 1,1 and ends at cell 5,6. Person B starts at the cell 5,1 and ends at the cell 1,6. And we know that they meet at this point. Then the key observation is that person A could have come from cells 3,3 or 2,4, and person B could have come from the cells 3,3 or 4,4. This is because we know that person A always moves either from i,j, he either moves to cell i+1,j or ij+1, and similarly person B moves from i,j to either i,j+1 or i-1,j, and based on that information given in the question, you can easily see that person B would have either come from here or from here, and similarly person A would have come from either here or here. Now we need to analyze only these three cells because these are the three spots from which the persons would have come to. But the key idea is that after the persons move to these cells, then the next cell which they can move to will be either this or this. So actually we need to look at these four cells. So this is the first main observation. Now the second idea is that if person A comes from the cell 3,3, then person B cannot come from the cell 3,3. This is because if they both came from the cell 3,3, then they would have intersected more than once, and this is invalid as per the question. Now this means that if A came from the cell 3,3, means that B came from the cell 4,4. Now once we know that A came from 3,3 and B came from 4,4, let's figure out in which direction can A go to. Now E can't come back to the cell 4,4, otherwise there would have been an intersection. E can only go to the cell 3,5. Similarly, B can't go to the cell 3,3 because he or she needs to go only up and right, and hence B has to go to the cell 2,4. That's the key idea in this case. So this is case 1, in which if A comes from the cell 3,3, then A needs to go to the cell 3,5 after the meeting point, and B needs to come from the cell 4,4 and cross the meeting point to go to the cell 2,4. Now you should realize that after this, these two paths are non-intersecting and they are going to be independent of each other. And that's case 1, in which A comes from the cell 3,3. Now similarly, we can analyze case 2, in which B comes from the cell 3,3. And as you can see, this case is almost identical to case 1. The only difference is which person is coming through this key cell. And based on that, the person needs to go to this cell. And similarly, the person coming from this cell or from this cell needs to go to the other cell by crossing M. Now we realize that there are four key points which we need to analyze. And hence, there will actually be four DP states with four transitions. So basically, this is grid DP four times. Now, let's try to understand what will our DP states be. So let's define these four DP states. DP1 of ij is the max gain for a path from 1,1 to i,j. DP2ij is the max gain from a path from n,1 to i,j. DP3 of ij is the max gain for a path from the cell i,j to n,n. And DP4 of ij is the max gain for a path from i,j to 1,n. And now you should be able to analyze these two cases, which I've written over here, easily in terms of DP1, DP2, DP3 and DP4. And the reason why this works is because DP1 represents the path from here to here, so from the start of A to this point, and then from this point to the end of A will be represented by DP3. Similarly, DP2 will represent from the start of B to this point, and then from this point to the end of B will be represented by DP4. So let's just write down the values of case 1 and case 2 using our DP state. So as you can see, in case 1, we have the total gain to be DP1 of ij minus 1. So basically, A reaches this cell, then A crosses the meeting point and goes to the cell i,j plus 1. And from i,j plus 1, A goes to the cell end A. And hence, this is the path for A would have a gain of DP1 ij minus 1. Then DP3 of ij plus 1. And similarly, the path for B would have a gain of DP2 of I minus 1 of j and DP4 of I plus 1 of j. So actually, this should be DP2 of I plus 1 of j and DP4 of I minus 1 of j. And that's because DP2 represents from n,1, so from the start to this cell. So that's I plus 1, and DP4 represents from I minus 1 to the end. And similarly, you can find out that case 2 would have DP1 of I minus 1, j. So basically, A goes from the start to over here. plus db3 of I plus 1 comma j. So a goes from here to the end. And b's gain would be dp2 of I j minus 1. So from here, so from the start to here. And then dp4 of I j plus 1. So from here to the end. And that basically is the answer. But we still have to find a way to evaluate dp1 to dp4. So let's just copy this over here and try to write the recurrence. So for the recurrence, dp1 of ij, dp2 of ij, dp3 of ij, and dp4 of ij will all include the term g of ij, and there'll be two possibilities for each value. So I'll just explain dp1 of ij, and you should be able to figure out the rest. Dp1 of ij is the max gain from 1,1 to I, j, and the key idea is that since we're moving from 1,1 to I, j, and each time we are going to I plus 1 or to j plus 1, hence we would have come from the point I minus 1 or j minus 1, and hence we need to take the maximum of those two values. Similarly, if I explain dp2 of ij, then we would have come from the cell I plus 1 comma j or I comma j minus 1, because each time we are either decrementing I or incrementing j. And similarly, you can work out the remaining two equations. Now that we have the recurrence and we have the two cases for the meeting points, let's just write the final step in our solution. So for the final step, after we have computed the DP tables, let's loop over all possible meeting points. So let's see that the current meeting point is I, j. And as per our case analysis, we would take the maximum of these two cases. So we would take the maximum of these two cases as per our case analysis. In case 1, we have this term, and in case 2, we have this term. And this is basically the sum of A's path and B's path for both the cases. And that's all that's there in our DP state and in the solution for this problem. One additional thing to remember in this problem, which cost me a wrong answer, was that the meeting points can only be from I is 2 to I is n minus 1 and j is 2 to j is m minus 1. So this is basically the loop bounds which we need to run, assuming we are using one-based indexing. And that's because the meeting points cannot lie on the border of the grid. And as you can see, you can't have a meeting point somewhere along here. Or if you look at the diagram here, you can see that this cannot really be a plausible meeting value. So this is actually incorrect. And the meeting values are actually bounded by this rectangle over here. So this rectangle is the only plausibility for the meeting points. Outside this rectangle, you can't have a meeting point over here. That's invalid. So you need to keep track, you need to basically run the loop for all meeting points from 2 to n minus 1 and 2 to n minus 1 only. So now let's look at the code. So in the code, first I read in the values of n and m. Then I declare and initialize to 0 5 2D arrays of size n plus 2 by m plus 2, because I'm using one-based indexing. And the first one is G, which is our grid. Then I have the four DP tables. Then I read in the values of G. And I also have an answer variable, which is the final answer. Then I compute the first DP table, the second one, the third one, and the fourth one, according to the exact same formulas which I have written in the whiteboard. And then in the final loop, we run for all I going from 2 to n minus 1. And all for all j going from 2 to m minus 1. And I do the case analysis. So this is basically case 1. And this is case 2. and I'll update answer to the maximum of what it originally was and the maximum of case 1 and case 2. So let's just run this code to see that it works on the sample test case. And as you can see, we got the output of 800, which is the correct output. And now let's submit this code to see that it gets accepted. So I hope you liked the 15th video of this dynamic programming problem solving series. As you could see, this problem illustrated the clever use of 4 DP tables and required some thinking to come up with the solution. The next video will be the last video of this DP problem solving series. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and do consider subscribing to my channel for more such content. Thank you.